Hello and welcome to the second part of our video series, What to do in case of a component not found exception. In the first part, we have seen how to handle a component change at the target component itself. And in this video, I will demonstrate to you how to handle a change in the component's hierarchy. All of those approaches and working techniques, which I will show to you, can be applied to any supported technology, again, which means you can use those techniques and follow those approaches for Java Swing, for Java FX, for Java SWT, or for web applications. I have created a test case for our car configurator demo application again. This test case will show some purchase order statistics, so how many vehicles, how many cars have been ordered at our company. So let's take a look at this test case first. The first step is to select a vehicle, then we will open the statistics dialog. In this dialog we will see some kind of table, so we will check for this kind of statistics table, and then we will close that dialog again. Then let's run that test case. So I select the test case, I press start test run, and we see everything went successful. The test case passed. Here in the status bar we see finished, no errors, everything seems to be fine. What else we could see is that our test case runs that that test case with the vehicle Rollo. That's what we see here in the selection of the car config application. And what I would like to do now is actually that I would like to change, to modify my test case in order to select mini golf in the next one. So I would like to change the selected vehicle in our test case. Therefore, I have to modify the test case, and that's happening via modifying that particular mouse click in our select vehicle sequence. There we have Rollo specified as target vehicle, and I'm going to change this now in order to select mini golf in the next one. Then I confirm that change, I select the test case again, and I press start test run again. And what we could see now is that it actually takes a little bit longer than in the previous one. It's still doing something, and so on, and so on, and so on. So, finally, after a couple of seconds, we get our error dialog again. This dialog is already well known to us, so this guy pops up if an error or an exception occurs during a test run. And now we will actually proceed with the same steps as shown in the last video. So we switch to the one log via pressing show one log. Then in that one log we press find next error in order to jump to the error message. And what do we see? Oh, it is our best friend. It's the component not found exception. So what do we have to do now? The first step is to figure out where it actually occurred. There we take a look at our sequence. It's the sequence check first row, and there it is the first mouse click which tries to select something in the table. So here we have a table and it tries to select the first entry of that table. So let's go to the screenshot of the dialogs in order to see whether everything is there. And here we have the screenshot of the statistics dialog, and there we also see the table. So actually everything seems to be fine. And now let's go back to the test suite in order to proceed the steps which we have seen in our first video. So go back to the test suite via right mouse click, find node in test suite. And because I would like to rerun that test case, I have to set a breakpoint via right mouse click breakpoint on off in order to be prepared once I run the rerun the test case I also close the statistics dialog because the test case is taking care of opening the dialog itself. And then I select the test case. Once I have selected that test case, I can rerun it via press start test run. That's what I'm doing now. At the breakpoint, we are in the pause mode. We check whether the dialog is already there. Yes, the statistics dialog is visible. So we expect the mouse clicks to work. So we press single step. And after a couple of seconds again, we get the error dialog. As this dialog is already known to us from the first video, we know it's not a timing issue, so we have to compare the component properties of those components which we record. So I confirm that dialog, I stop the replay, then I go to the mouse click, and in order to figure out what properties the components have of that component have been recorded, I jump to the component via locate component. There at that table node, I set a mark via marks toggle mark. So we got our blue dot here again. Then I re-record the component, so a new mouse click on the new table. I stop the recording. I select the newly recorded mouse click. Then I jump to that component as well via right mouse click locate component. And I mark this new table as well via marks toggle mark. Analyzing differences works as shown in the first video. So where are our blue dots? Actually, we should have two. Yes, we see we have two. It's here in table one and here in the second table. Now we have to take care those tables are not at the same in the same parent components. So we need to walk up the hierarchy level here, the parents, to the first level where we actually see two blue dots. And in our case, that's the level of the dialogues. Here we see two blue dots. So those two dots have been propagated to those dialogues because we have marked those tables at the beginning using the locate component command. That's a default feature of Qf test. So we know that we have the actual difference at that level. And now we can proceed as we have seen in the first video. So we click at the first dialog, we click at the second, we click at the first again at the second, figuring out where is the difference. In our case, we can see that the difference is at the feature attribute, which actually represents the title of the dialog. That's what we also can see here in the car config application. So it seems that our title here has some kind of dynamic values. In the car config application, that dynamic value represents the selected vehicle. But in our case, we actually would like our test case to work with any kind of vehicle, so we have to replace that specific vehicle title or vehicle name. And in our case, we can do that via selecting the sregapps box beyond the feature, and there we replace the feature attribute, so we replace the vehicle name with dot star, which actually represents a so-called regular expression, which means that any character after or following the statistics text is okay for us. So this text will now work for Rollo, it will work for Minigolf, it will work for any kind of vehicle. And it's important to select the sregapps box here. And I confirm that change. Then let's try this. So let's rerun the test case. First of all, let's remove the breakpoint because that's not necessary anymore. Right mouse click breakpoint on off and close the statistics dialog as well, as the test case will take care of opening it. So we select the test case and we press start test run. Yeah, and it seems the test case succeeded. So we have resolved our component not found exception. And actually we are at the end of our second video, how to resolve a component not found exception. In this video I have shown you how to resolve such component issues if they are not at the component themselves, like in our case at the table, but if they are appearing in the component hierarchy. You can apply the techniques of adapting the name as shown in the first video, or adapting the feature like shown here. In any cases of this component recognition, just try to follow those approaches, and if you can't get your test running and if you can't get your issue solved, then please contact the QFS support via support@qfs.de. Please send a brief description of the issue as well as the test suites containing the previous and the new recordings of the components as well as the run logs. I hope you enjoyed listening to that video and I wish you good luck in testing.